Welcome to my top 10 worst warlords in recent history. Number 1, Khan 2012. He got all kids to fight for him in dirt factories of Thunderdome, Africa. Number 2, Tom Montone. He was not made up by El Pinocchio to become a warlord and smoked a lot of cocaine, crystal cocaine. Number 3, Emperor Pope. This guy right here was a special one. He owned his own big old place known as the Pope Estates, where he killed people or something. I don't know, Christians are weird. Number 4, Boy Fire. He started out with his own restaurant, but you know, he had enough. One day, and just started eating the opposition. Gross, I know, but you know, when you wanna grow an empire, you gotta, you know, fucking war clan, a warlord place, you gotta, you know, kill people to get there. And you know, you just gotta fucking kill the opposition and become the only one there. You just be the only one standing. Number 5, Dusty Fred, and this boy over here, he went ghost. After seeing, you know, Emma from Danny Phantom sing that one song, I fucking like remember, I don't know. And he had his own band afterwards called Limp Dick. Now he owns the music industry with his war industry of music. Number 6, Terry A. Davis. He went insane after he saw some innocent CIA railroad workers working a night shift because they had flashlights. He ran over hard, and after running a bit from the police after he ran over, you know, it's a crime, I don't know why, he went into hiding and ran his own OS, Temple OS, converting a whole nation into his little fucking army or whatever, I don't fucking know, cult? Yeah, there we go. He thinks he's divine king, yeah. Number 7, Billy Doors. Starting out as some nerd in the neo-Turkish hyper-war-driven country of Finland, he saw a group of old ladies and gave them guns, and he took over the superpower that is Finland, with the power of old ladies and guns. Number 8, Sam Vector Graphics. Born in the Inland Crater colony of Canada, he decided that it could use some improvement, and then called it the Sacred Land of Upper Class Ontario, afterwards colonizing the rest of the Americas back in the 75,448 before Christ. Number 9, Elliot Oliver Robertson Roger. This supreme gentleman was so handsome that he got an army just for his manly charm. After he killed his army, he went to the local deli and annexed it until the military shock paratrooper police force arrived and took him down. Number 10, Alex Jones. Alexander Eric Jones is the leader of the New World and make sure that the globalists regret everything they've done. He told me personally he'll put Hillary's head on a stick like the end of Duel with Digital Rabbit's head on the bloody stick. You know, that was a pretty rad scene, I'm not gonna lie.